Over the past several years, their appearances outside prison walls have had a disconcerting regularity. Men condemned by Illinois as convicted murderers have been shown to be not guilty and been set free.
As a college senior, I had the opportunity to take David Protess's investigative journalism class. And I don't know why I took the class. I took it because it sounded fun. And I ended up working on the case of Anthony Porter. Anthony had come within 50 hours of execution, exactly a week before we started class. And he received a stay at the last minute, but he didn't receive a stay because anyone thought he was innocent. He received a stay because his IQ had been tested at 51, and there were questions about whether he was competent to be executed. We went and we reenacted the crime, and we found out that the eyewitness who said he had seen Anthony Porter committing the crime couldn't have seen it at all. Then the eyewitness recanted. Then we tracked down the ex-wife of the person we thought was the real killer, and she told us on video that she had been there when her husband committed the crime. And a week later, her husband confessed to private investigator Paul Cialino on video, and Anthony was released on the state's motion 2 days later. And I can't really describe, I had no idea that the justice system worked like that before I started I just didn't know.
This was the third person released by the journalism students at Northwestern. And of course, it doesn't say much for our legal system. When people spend 16 years on death row for a crime they don't commit or didn't commit, and that ultimately comes to light not because of the police or the prosecution or the defense lawyers or the judicial system, but because a journalism class at Northwestern took it on as a class project to see whether or not these people were guilty or not. You know, if those students had taken chemistry that semester, these folk would have been executed.